The Renewable Fuel Standard, RFS, program, created under the Energy Policy Act of 2005, established the first mandatory blend levels for renewable fuel in the United States. The RFS was amended in 2007, known as RFS 2, to include renewable fuel replacements for diesel. It requires companies that refine, import, or blend fossil fuels to meet certain individual quotas based on the volume of fuel they introduce into the market. The RFS 2 encompasses all renewable fuels and requires 4 billion gallons of renewable fuel be blended into transportation fuel in 2006, increasing to 36 billion gallons by 2022. Most of this is corn-based ethanol, but fuels that reduce more greenhouse gas emissions, GHG, like biodiesel, require 9 billion gallons to be blended into transportation fuel in 2008, increasing to 21 billion gallons by 2022. The Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, is charged with administrating the RFS 2. To implement the program, EPA established 4 biofuels categories, each with a specific volume mandate and the amount of GHG each fuel emits over its life cycle in comparison to the petroleum fuels they displace. Since circumstances change, RFS 2 allowed the EPA considerable flexibility in setting actual mandated volumes, but EPA's goal is to update the quotas each year by November 30th. EPA has repeatedly missed the deadline and the volumes are well below the levels laid out by Congress. The graph shows the total renewable volume obligations, RVOs, the advanced biofuels as suggested by Congress, and the actual volume of advanced biofuels ultimately required by the EPA. To comply with EPA regulations, fuel refiners and importers are assigned an RVO, which represents the amount of biofuel that they are required to introduce into the petroleum fuel supply each year. These obligated parties can either blend their fuel with the required amount of biofuel or buy credits from others who blend more than their required amount. Obligated parties have 2 years to fulfill their annual RVO. To track compliance, the EPA created a system of tradable credits known as Renewable Identification Numbers, or RINs. Each gallon of biofuel has a unique RIN attached to it. For biodiesel, the value is 1.5 and represents the number of gallons that can be claimed for compliance purposes for every gallon of biodiesel. The EPA has experienced several challenges administering the RFS program. There have been multiple cases of RIN fraud. As the fraud accelerated, the EPA enacted the Quality Assurance Program, QAP, in which a third-party auditor evaluates biofuel producers to certify the production in compliance with the regulation. Despite the problems, the RFS program has played an important role in the continued development of the biodiesel industry. Learn more at biodieseleducation.org.